हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू द सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ क्लास 9th एंड द पार्ट 2 ऑफ चैप्टर 2 व्हिच इज़ द साउंड ऑफ म्यूजिक. इन दिस सेक्शन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द शहनाई मास्ट्रो उस्ताद बिस्मिल्लाह खान, द विनर ऑफ भारत रत्न, द हाईएस्ट सिविलियन अवार्ड इन इंडिया. हिज डेडिकेशन टू म्यूजिक एंड हिज लव फॉर इंडिया. Pungi, a musical instrument, was banned by Aurangzeb, Emperor Aurangzeb, because of its shrill and unpleasant voice. In fact, it was regarded more as a noise maker rather than a musical instrument. So, in Aurangzeb's court, Pungi was banned, which was also a musical instrument, and Pungi is supposed to be the origin of Shehnai. It was modified and perfected by a barber, that means a Nai, who belonged to a family of a professional musicians. He played it in the chamber of the king. Its sound was so appreciated by the emperor that it was made a part of Nobat. Since it was played for the first time in Shah's chamber by a Nai, it became to be known as Shah Nai, that means Shah Nai. Traditionally, it was played in the temples and was also played in auspicious domestic occasions also. The sound was so appreciated and was made auspicious that it became a part of Indian music. Bismillah belonged to Banaras Gharana. He was born in 1916 at Dumrao in Bihar. The famous Dumrao Maharaja, as we all know. At the age of 6, he moved to Banaras. When he was 5 years old, he used to visit the Bihariji temple and sing Bhojpuri Chaita. As you all know, Chaita. For his melodious singing, he used to earn a big laddu of 1.25 kg from the local Bhojpur king, that is also known as Dumrao Maharaj, who recently passed away. When he moved to Banaras, he was under the guidance of his maternal uncle Ali Bakhsh, and he started picking up the finer nuances of Shehnai. That means he wanted to make Shehnai a more perfect music instrument. He used to practice on the banks of River Ganges. The themes of his music were deeply affected by the sounds of flowing water of the Ganga. Ustad Bismillah Khan is also a Shehnai maestro. He took to music early in life and he was 3 years old in the company of his maternal uncle. He used to practice different notes at the river Ganges at Banaras Ghat and also took music to a different height. He achieved all the success in his life through the hard work and the determination and produced some perfect notes of Shehnai, which made him famous worldwide and also made him earn the highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna. Once one of his disciples told him that why can't you come to America, the United States of America, we'll replicate the scene of River Ganges and we'll try to impart education or play music on the duplicate, the replicated version of River Ganges. So he told that you can take everything, the temples of Banaras, the different things, you can replicate everything, but would you be able to carry River Ganges to the United States of America, the natural River Ganges? So this was not only a question, an impossible task also, which was put forward in front of the disciple, the student of Ustad Bismillah Khan. So he was surprised to hear this and could not do anything rather than to pull his feet backwards. So this was the story of Ustad Bismillah Khan. He also played this chapter. The context of the chapter tells you something about the communal harmony, the secularism, there is no difference between Hindu and Muslim. Ustad Bismillah Khan, being a Muslim, played Shehnai at the famous Vishwanath Temple in Banaras. Without his offering of Shehnai, the gates of the temple were not opened. So, the chapter not only tells you about the music, it also tells you about the equality, the secularism, the communal harmony, and there is no difference between people. This was the end of the chapter, Ustad Bismillah Khan. He also in his last words said that you can't take river Ganga to any part of the world, and you can just not replicate everything. Something which is natural can't be obtained anywhere. It can't be replicated. So that's all. We'll move to the next chapter someday another. Thank you.